Hello dear students, today we are going to learn a topic flower. Flower under chapter morphology of flowering plants. The flower is the morphology of flowering plant of class 11th. This is the chapter number 5. Now today's topic is flower. Flower is the reproductive part of the plant. Especially flower is the one of the important part of the plant. If plant produces flower, it means that plant is going to reproduce. Plants especially develop from the, it is a modified shoot. It is a modified shoot, especially shoot part, especially tip part, lateral branches, tip parts especially that are modified into the flower, and the flower having condensed node and internodes. In students, if the plant going to produce flower, it means it is further going to produce fruits as well as seeds. And you know that seed is the one of the important reproductive parts that enclosed inside the seed in angiosperms and inside the fruit in the angiosperm, and these seed having capacity of propagation. Yeah, you can say to form new plants. Okay. So in plants, the instead of gamete, here nuclei are present. Here nuclei are present, and these nuclei are considered as a gamete. These nuclei are considered under a gametes, and these gametes undergoes fusion process. What type of fusion occur in angiosperm? You have learned in detail in class 12 about reproduction in flowering plants. But here only morphology and what terminology and taxonomy, taxonomical point of view are discussed in this chapter only. So in this chapter we are not going to learn about only focusing on the reproduction process. But in angiosperm, the flowering plant, the nuclei are present, and that nuclei act as a gamete and involve in the fusion as well as formation of new zygotes and endosperms. Now the next topic in the flower is parts of typical flower. Parts of typical flower means flower is made up of which part? How many parts flower is made up of? Especially this can be understood by the preparing diagram of the flower. This is a flower, one of the part of the flower. This is the structure of flower. And students, you know that this is a stigma. This is a style. And this one is a ovary. These all are female reproductive part. Especially this is called gynoecium. And gynoecium is considered under the female reproductive part. This is a symbol of female reproductive part. And unit of gynoecium is pistil. Unit of gynoecium is pistil. Another name of pistil is called carpel. Sometimes carpel are used in some book, and somewhere they are pistil are used. But this is one of the central part of the flower, especially female reproductive part. This is a anther, and anther attached to the flower base, flower parts, it is called filament, and both anther and filament is called androecium, and this androecium is the male reproductive part. This is a symbol of male reproductive part. And a unit of androecium is, it is called stamen. Unit of androecium is stamen. Clear? Now this is a colorful part of the flower. It is a fascinating part that present inside the flower. It is called corolla. Corolla, and unit of corolla is petal. In a flower, many number of petals, especially fixed number of petals, many number of stamen, fixed number of stamens, all there, and many number of gynoecums and fixed number of gynoecium are found, depend on the plants. And this is the green photosynthetic type of part is called calyx. It is the outermost covering of the flower, and the unit of the calyx is sepal. Unit of the calyx is sepal, and this one is called flower base. Flower base, or you can say it is a thalamus. Thalamus. Thalamus or flower base, and this is a part by which flower attached to the any branch or branch of the plant. It is called pedicel. Okay. Now, students, once again I want to discuss each and every part of the plant, especially each and every part of the flower. This is the pedicels that attach flower with the plants. That attach the flower with the plant. Okay. This is the flower base is called thalamus, on which different floral part exist. Okay. This is the thalamus zone, and this is the another important part. Especially you can see the fruit is known as apple. Apple is also called false fruit. It is not developed from ovary. Apple is developed from the thalamus. You can remember here. This is a calyx. Calyx is a outermost covering. If the flower in at the bud stage, if the flower at the bud stage, suppose this is a bud. At flower at the bud stage, then this calyx help in the covering of the flower at the bud stage. Means calyx help in the covering of the flower at the bud stage. Okay. So this one is the one of the important part. If the now this is a corolla, that is a colorful part. It may be red color, orange color, yellow color, many color they shows. And this is one of the important part. It attract a lot of number of insect that visit flowers, insect visit flowers, and if they visit one flower, then after visit another flower, then help in the agency by which transmission of pollen takes place, from one place to the another. That's why it causes cross pollination. Means indirectly corolla help in the cross pollination by attracting a lot number of insect. Unit of corolla is petal. Some flower the petal in number 3, 4, 5, 6 and many. Especially you can see the marigold plant flower corolla and rose plants, they show many corolla. Okay. And if you can see the mustard plant and some special like thevetia peruviana, this type of plants, this shows a fixed number of, a limited number of 3, 4, or 5 corolla present in that case. This is the second oral. Now the third oral is the androecium. Androecium is the one of the important part. Androecium is the male reproductive part, means it bear pollen grain inside the anther. It bear pollen grain. When the anther mature, the pollen grain dispersed and pollen grain reaches to the stigma. It may be on same flower, may be on different flower. It may be on same flower, it is called self-pollination. It may be on different flower, it is called cross-pollination. What is the advantage of self as well as cross-pollination? You have already learned in class 10th standard, but you can further study in class 12, chapter 2. Now, this one is anther, and this is a filament. It is attached to the base of the the flower flower base. Okay, so this one is a androecium. Now the fourth hole that is present in the flower, it is a mid section, is called ovary. Gynoecium. Gynoecium is made up of three part: stigma, on which the pollen dust, pollen start germinating by absorbing stigmatic fluid, as well as the style by which pollen tube passes, and ovary that bear ovule, and ovule bear female gametes, and the pollen tube fertilize there. Okay, this type of phenomena especially happen in case of angiosperm. Double fertilization phenomena is also occur. So you can say this one is a different part of the flower. And in taxonomy, what is another term generally used? Let us discuss one by one. If a flower, remember this point, all this point, students, because this is a very important part of the morphology of flowering plant, and generally the Bentham and Hooker system of classification that read in India, learn in India, especially follow the floral characters and advantageous character for the classification of different plants. Okay, classification of different plants. Now students, parts of flower deals one by one heading. Flowers, especially flowers may be incomplete. First point, let us discuss first point, parts of flower. Especially if in flower all parts are present, it is called complete flower. What it is called? Complete flower. Complete flower means all floral part are present. Okay, all floral part are present, especially calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium in a single flower. It is called complete flower. If any one part are absent in the flower, it is called incomplete flower. Okay, any part is absent, this one is a call incomplete flower. Similarly, the unisexual flower, if you are talking about the unisexual flower, it is a unisexual, or it is also called dioecious flower. Dioecious, it is a generally either male part or female parts only present. Either male part or female part only present. This type of flower is called unisexual flower. Means either male part, that is either androecium or gynoeciums are present in the flower, it is called unisex. Suppose a papaya plant, it is a unisexual plant. Female plant are separate from the male plants, and only female plant able to produce fruit, that are called unisexual flower. But it is also termed as dioecious condition. What? Dioecious conditions are dioecious flower. Okay, and if a flower is bisexual, if flower is bisexual, okay, this situation is called monoecious condition. Monoecious condition, especially bisexual flower, if the flower having both reproductive part. Especially I want to discuss one more terminology in the flower. If the flower only have two part, one is accessory, and you can say one is the reproductive part. The reproductive part consider androecium and gynoecium. Androecium and gynoecium. And non-reproductive part, especially of the flower, is called non-reproductive part of the flower is called calyx as well as corolla. Non-reproductive part are considered calyx as well as corolla. It is called non-reproductive because they are not going to produce any type of gamete in the flower, and only reproductive part, androecium and gynoecium, going to produce a gamete in the flower. Okay, so this one is a reproductive and non-reproductive. You can say accessory part and non-accessory part. Reproductive part is called accessory part, and it is called non-accessory parts. Now if the flower having pedicel that flower is called pedicellate flower. Okay, pedicellate flower, it means flower having pedicel. What does it means? If the flower attach with the stalk through the branch is called pedicellate flower. But if flower not having pedicels, suppose this one is a floral axis, from which flower is a rise, and this is a flower and this is a pedicel. This type of flower is called pedicellate flower. And second is called sessile flower. It means the flower is not having pedicel. Pedicel is absent. In this case, pedicel absent. Okay, and this type of flower is called sessile flower. Suppose this is a flower, this is called sessile flower, and here pedicel is absent in this case. Okay, students, this one is a condition of pedicellate as well as sessile flower. Now the fourth heading is parts of flower. Now position of floral parts. Okay, now especially three positions of floral part generally observe. First position is hypogynous flower. Especially if the floral part arise from the base of the ovary. Suppose this is a ovary, and all floral part arise from this zone. Only this zone only. This is the anther. This is the ovary, and all floral part arise below the ovary. It means that ovary can seen externally. From outer side, ovary can easily be seen. This type of flower is called hypogynous. Hypo means below. Or gynoecium means below the gynoecium. If a floral part is arise, this type of flower is called hypogynous situation. What situation? Hypogynous situation. The hypogynous flower is also called superior ovary containing flower. Suppose gynoecium is represented by G, and dash is present below the G, it indicate the gynoecium present superior conditions. G under dash. Okay, now so this one is a hypogynous flower. Second is a epigynous flower. What? Epigynous. Epigynous flower. What does it means? If the all floral part, suppose this is a gynoecium, and if all floral parts arise above the ovary, and externally ovary cannot be seen. Ye dekh sakte hain, you can see the other floral part like calyx, like corolla, androecium, all things are arise above the ovary. This is a ovary, and due to which ovary cannot seen externally. Okay, ईपी गाइनस, ईपी का मतलब यूपी में ईपी, सॉरी यूपी मतलब मींस अपर एंड गाइनस मींस गाइनोसियम के, ओके गाइनोसियम मींस इफ द अबव द ओवरी फ्लोरल पार्ट इज अराइज, अबव द ओवरी फ्लोरल पार्ट इज अराइज दिस सिचुएशन इज कंसिडर अंडर द ईपी गाइनस फ्लावर. द फ्लावर द फ्लावर प्रोड्यूसिंग सॉरी द फ्लोरल पार्ट प्रोड्यूस सच टाइप ऑफ फ्लोरल स्ट्रक्चर्स दैट प्रोड्यूस इन द फ्लावर इज कंसिडर मीन्स सच टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर इज कंसिडर अंडर द इन्फीरियर ओवरी कंडीशन मीन्स इन ओवरी कैन नॉट बी ऑब्जर्व एक्सटर्नली इन्फीरियर ओवरी कंडीशंस हियर द ओवरी अकर इन्फीरियर ओवरी कंडीशंस हियर इन ओवरी अकर below the floral parts and externally we cannot observe the ovary. Such type of flower is called epigynous or inferior ovary containing flower. Now third flower is perigynous flower. Here the floral part arise neither above the ovary nor below the ovary. Means here the floral part arise between the ovary, in between the ovary. Suppose this is a floral part, okay, this is a floral part that all are arise from the middle portion of the ovary, okay, from the middle portion of the ovary, and this situation of ovary is considered under the perigynous flower. Peri means in between the ovary, means half ovary you can see externally, half you cannot see externally, clear. And this overall situation is considered under flower is called perigynous, and it is called flower of semi-superior and semi-inferior condition, semi-superior as well as semi-inferior condition, okay. So this one is a semi-superior and semi-inferior ovary. Now if you are talking about the each and every topic, next one is a neuter flower. As like unisexual, bisexual conditions, another condition is called neuter flower. Bisexual, it is called, third is a neuter flower. I already discussed unisexual and bisexual condition. What is a neuter flower? If in any flower both androecium and gynoecium are absent, that type of flower is called neuter flower, okay. If both gynoecium and androecium are absent, what does it mean? Neuter flower, it means that flower not bear androecium and gynoecium. Like sunflower ray florets is considered under the neuter flower, okay. Now let us discuss one by each and every part of the flower one by one. Now we start with the outermost whorl is called calyx. What is calyx? It is a outermost whorl. What they do in the flower? They cover flower at the bud stage. Cover flower at the bud stage. Second, if we are talking about the number of sepal, it is generally of 3, 4, 5 and many. And what is called cohesions about the calyx, okay. In cohesions, it generally talk, first topic is if all sepal are free, it is all sepal are free, this situation is called polysepalous condition. Polysepalous condition, in which suppose a flower cover at the bud stage and each and every sepal separate one another and all are not fused, means here not fused situation. This situation is called polysepalous. If all sepal fused at last also, okay, it is called gamosepalous condition. In gamosepalous condition, all sepal fused. And what different type of aestivation that are found in this case? Aestivation means how the calyx arrange. Aestivation generally are seen in case of flower, it is a bulbate, second is a imbricate, third one is a twisted, okay, fourth one is a quincuncial. This all type of aestivation are present in case of flower. I think this all type of aestivation you can see in next class, especially next class, you can see at a higher level of the class also. At this level, the bulbate, twisted, imbricate and quincuncial aestivation is not discussed in detail. Now, similar case happen in case of corolla. Similar case happen in corolla. What is corolla? Corolla is a second oral. What? It is called second oral of flower. Clear? Second oral of the flower. Second things, it is a colorful. It is colorful, attract insect, produce nectar, and help due to insect, it causes pollination. Okay. Second unit of corolla is called petal. If talking about number of petal, then petal are of 3, 4, 5 and many. In a flower, many petal. Suppose if you are talking about the rose plant as well as helianthus, especially the marigold and marigold, then you find many type of what? Corolla present in that case, marigold as well as rose plant. Second thing, if we are talking about the cohesion, same condition as like sepals, polypetalous, but here petal unit, it is called polypetalous condition, and second is called gamopetalous condition. In gamopetalous, the petals are fused, okay, and in polysepalous, petals are free. Okay, this all situation occur in that case. Corolla is also shows different type of aestivations, generally bulbate, imbricate, twisted and quincuncial. This type of bacillary aestivation, one of the important aestivation that present in case of corolla. Bacillary, bulbate, imbricate, twisted and quincuncial, this type of aestivation generally observed in the corolla case. Okay, so this one is a different part of the flower which are generally used as a taxonomical conditions. If you are talking about the different attachment, if in gynoecium, third part is a androecium. Now
I will discuss androecium in next class in detail, students. Androecium and gynoecium I will discuss in next class. And then after about androecium and gynoecium, what is the symbols used in used during the floral formula formation, and what type of diagram can be used at the time of floral diagram formation. Thank you, students.